Get ready to make a match. It's match game. Meet today's panel. Kevin McDonald, Debra DiGiovanni, Scott Thompson, Eddie Della, Leah Miller, and Sean Cullen. It's the game where we fill in the blanks with cash. It's match game.
Welcome to Match Game. I'm your host, Darrin Rose, and I appreciate that welcome, Sean.
It was a kung fu welcome.
The kung fu welcome. Yeah. I enjoyed that. Let's say hi to all of our panelists.
Hi, guys.
How are you?
Hello, Darrin Bear.
We did have, before the show, an audience question. Somebody wanted to know if there were lyrics to the Match Game
That's
song.
Absolutely,
and I thought, Sean,
right,
you'd be the guy to answer that.
I think
that
it's a good show to do it on because this is the 700th show. Do you really want to make a match? Do you want to make a match with me? Do you want to write something on a card and then show it to my face? Then you maybe win some money. But if you guess wrong, then you don't. Holy cow, I guess you lost. Get off the show, you jerk.
How's that? Very nice. A beautiful song. With that, let's meet our contestants.
Let's do it.
We're live.
Let's meet our first contestant. She enjoys painting, doodling, and reviewing things online. Please welcome Sarah Summers, everyone.
One of those. Sarah, how are you?
Good, good. And our second contestant comes from a long line of filmmakers. His grandfather helped invent IMAX technology, right? Yes. Leo Lowe, everybody. Leo, how are you?
Good, good. Good.
We're all here. We're all friends. Let's play some match game. Let me tell you what we do in the first round. We play fill in the blanks. The goal is to match as many of your answers to those of our panelists as you can. Every correct match is worth 50 points. At the end of the first three rounds, whoever has the most points wins. And then you get your points turned into dollars, and then you go on to play our Super Match and Star Wheel rounds.
Oh, my!
Yeah, it's great. So, Sarah, backstage, you won the coin toss, so you face a decision. Would you like question A or question B?
I'm going to go with A.
A. Oh. All right, here we go. Jay said to the sex therapist, I took your advice and tried role-playing with my wife. She liked it when I acted like a cowboy, but she got furious when I tried to blank her. Jay said to the sex therapist, I took your advice and tried role-playing with my wife. She liked it when I acted like a cowboy, but she got furious when I tried to blank her.
It's just all filthy.
That's what I like. I can always tell you because you always giggle like nefariously and then you write nothing down.
I don't
have anything. All right, Deb, we're just waiting.
Okay.
I'm excited by this.
You're excited by this?
Ow. Yeah.
All right, here we go. Deb is ready.
Ready.
Sarah. Jay said to the sex therapist, I took your advice and tried role-playing with my wife. She liked it when I acted like a cowboy, but she was furious when I tried to blank her.
Spank her.
Spank her.
That, what does that have
I'm
to
trying
do
to spank her.
Cowboy.
That is a timid response from the audience.
We were cowboys and we used to spank each other. Remember those times? Spank the horses.
No, they don't.
Remember spanking the horses?
That's dope.
The old
that
days?
Does sound like a euphemism to spank the horse.
Sure does.
Kevin.
I thought I went for the obvious sex answer. I'm sorry.
Ride me.
That's good.
Seriously, ride me. Right. Deb.
I said lasso.
Lasso, right. Right, she's uptight. She doesn't like the rope action.
Well,
Scott.
I went with the classy answer. Buck her.
Buck her. That's excellent. Eddie?
Mm-mm. Slap?
Slap, spank?
Yeah.
Is that close enough?
Yeah.
Doesn't make it
right.
Good answer. Slapping. What do the cowboys slap? I don't understand.
Each other.
Leah?
The old slap fights.
Tied her up with a rope.
Tied her up with a rope. Same. Right.
Same thing.
Think alike. Yeah. 50 Shades of Fun. Sean.
I would, I thought you might try and rob her like a stagecoach.
Right.
Like a bandit?
Which is such an elaborate role play.
Put
it's
all
hard
your
to get.
Luggage on top of her, and then have an old grizzled man with a beard with a shotgun beside the luggage, and then you ride up and steal the gold from within her.
Right, but it's so hard to
that's
pull
really
off.
Long to yeah. do. So ride, that's
right.
The
right.
Sorry.
Sarah, you're on the board.
50 points.
Thanks to young Della Seppi over here. Leo, let me ask you this. The microbrewery manager said, this batch of organic pale ale may taste strange because while it was brewing, a blank dropped into the vat. All right. The microbrewery manager said, this batch of organic pale ale may taste strange because while it was brewing, a blank dropped into the vat.
Okay.
Jeez.
Pale ale. Organic pale ale. You're making it this brewery.
What? But I would be traveling like in the vat?
Into the vat, like the where they're brewing it. Yeah.
I'm bad at this game.
Darrin, that's a picture of a cat.
That's adorable.
Deb, can you show that again?
That's adorable.
We want to make sure we get Deb here.
Let's see your headshot.
Deb's
it's a fat
photo.
Cat.
Don't judge my cat.
Very nice. All right, Scott, are you got one? We're going to need
can
one.
Can I sit this one out?
No.
Yeah, you can.
You want to copy me?
You can write the word pass
okay.
on your thing.
Okay. Fell?
Do you want to use Deb's picture
something
of a cat?
Something fell into the vat, Scott.
Something fell in it?
Yeah.
It could be anything that fell into a vat.
Caused a strange flavor in that pale ale.
A boot.
Anything
something
that could
weird.
Fall. Would be an acceptable answer.
Something
all right,
weird
here we go.
Fill in
here we
something
go.
Weird.
Leo. Evidently, this is a tough one.
Oh, yeah.
Let me read it for you again. The microbrewery manager said this batch of organic pale ale may taste strange because while it was brewing, a blank dropped into the vat.
Let me go with person.
A person.
Oh, that would make it taste strange.
Right? A person. Let's see what we can do. Kevin, we'll have to go a little bit quickly here.
I concentrated on the word organic. It's part of a person.
An organ. Part of a person, but not good enough. Deb?
I said a small person, child.
A small person. That's a person. Yeah, Leo's on the board. Scott?
I said a bat.
A bat.
To the bat.
Right. That's perfectly acceptable.
Because it rhymed with bat.
Yeah. Yeah, and that's enough. Eddie?
I said rat.
A rat. Also using the rhyming scheme.
Why are you laughing at that answer? I said the same thing.
Of course you did.
There are no wrong answers.
Sean?
There are no wrong answers. And I thought since it's pale ale, an albino fell in.
Also a person.
Also a person. I believe Leo pulls into the lead with 100 points. Sarah's got 50, and we'll be right back with more Match Game. Get to know our contestants a little bit better. Oh. Sarah, what kind of stuff do you review online?
Random stuff, mostly celebrity gossip, and probably even this show.
This show, right.
Uh-oh.
You review the celebrity gossip? Like, good gossip, bad gossip.
I review the scandal or whatever's going on.
Oh, okay, right. Yeah, probably more words than I just used. Nah, good gossip. That's not enough. It's not enough. Leo, your family is filmmakers. Did anybody ever take you on set?
No, because I'm a terrible filmmaker. I wouldn't be very good on set.
Are you blaming your family for this?
No, I'm blaming my lack of trying to make films.
That's always held me back, is never trying. Yeah.
I know the feeling. Yeah.
Right. All right, let's go here. Sarah, you're behind, so you'll choose first. You have a question A or a question B to select?
B.
B, here we go. Elliot the masochist really loves pain. That's why he keeps his pet porcupine in his blank.
No.
Well, you consider that. Elliot the masochist really loves pain. That's why he keeps his pet porcupine in his blank. Oh, this one's very speedy. Everyone's ready immediately.
Everyone's got some.
You got some?
Hopefully she'll get some points.
I wrote a word.
Here we go, Sarah. Elliot the masochist really loves pain. That's why he keeps his pet porcupine in his...
The front of his pants.
In his pants?
Yeah.
Can we just say pants?
Fine.
Right, okay, we'll just say pants. We'll say pants. I like how you tried to make it sexual. The front of the pants. But that's all, let's see if we can find her some matches. Kevin.
As Paul Lynn would say, in his pants.
On the way. His pants, we got a match. Deb.
We're so close. Pants.
Pants, boom. Scott?
Same place I keep my porcupine, in his pants.
His pants? Where else did you keep a porcupine? Eddie? I'm
starting to feel a better energy with me and Sarah, because I said pants.
Things are turning up. Leah?
Underwear.
Underwear. Oh,
they're
underpants. They're underpants, but I think
the.
What? They gave that to her? Yes. They gave that to her. All right. The intent was the same. All right, Sean.
I was going to say next to the picture of his dead mother. But instead, I said panties.
Panties, which I think is going to count as well. Sarah, running the table.
Wow.
Leo, let's see what you can do with this. Zambini the human cannonball said, in fact, I'm self-propelled. Just before I get into my cannon, I eat blank.
Okay. Now we're getting clear.
You consider it? Zambini the human cannonball said, in fact, I'm self-propelled. Before I get into my cannon, I eat blank.
Zambini is a strange name, man.
Zambini is a bit of a weird name.
Zamboni.
Yeah. All right, Leo.
Oh.
Here we go. Okay. Zambini the human cannonball said, in fact, I am self-propelled. Just before I get into the cannon, I eat...
a whole lot of beans.
Beans! We've got beans. Perfectly logical. See what we can do for you, Kevin.
I said beans!
Beans!
I said lots of beans!
All right, nicely done, Deb. Scott.
Beans!
Yes.
Beans, all right. Eddie.
I love farts, so beans.
A little personal note there, and I thought that was a nice touch.
I thought you knew me.
Right. Yeah.
I didn't say beans, I said gunpowder.
Gunpowder, eats gunpowder, which is perfectly logical. Leah, you're so hard on yourself. It's fine.
That's good.
Fine, you're doing great. There's no right or wrong answers, except
that one was wrong. That was the
wrong answer, yeah. But only in fact, not in spirit. John.
I wanted to say a tiny proto-universe that expands quickly. But I didn't. I said beans, too.
Beans. Wow. Beans, there we go. Leo's at 350. Sarah's at 350. It's a tie game. So who knows what's going to happen in the matchup round?
I don't know.
You don't know. We're back. The score is tied at 350 apiece, and now it's time for the matchup round, where you guys can build up your scores by fast matching with a celebrity partner of your choice against the clock. Now, Sarah, because it's a tie game, you won the coin toss backstage, so you will choose first. Who will your panelists be?
Eddie, thank you for giving me my first point, but I have to go with Debra. Oh.
Ooh, I like it.
What am I gonna do?
Lead him on a little bit and then punch him.
That's yeah.
Tugging on his little heartstrings.
Let's do this. Sarah, let's win this. Okay?
Yeah? Okay. Here's what we're going to do, Sarah. We're going to show you a series of phrases. On the panel in front of you, you choose your best response to each phrase. Every time Deb, not Eddie, chooses the same thing, you get 50 points. All right? We'll do as many as we can in 45 seconds. If you are ready, we'll get 45 seconds on the clock. You ready? Mm-hmm. All right, let's go. Jack in the box, jack of all trades.
Jack of all trades.
No match. Hail Mary, hailstorm.
Hail Mary.
Match. Gridiron, gridlock.
Gridlock.
Match. Draw bridge, draw blood.
Draw blood.
Match. Catnap, cat call.
Catnap!
Match. Paper boy, paper trail.
Paper boy!
Match. Fruit salad, fruit smoothie.
Fruit salad.
Match. Eyelash, eyebrow.
Eyelash.
Match.
Wow.
Horse race, horseshoe.
Horseshoe.
Match.
Wow.
Break the silence, break the...
Oh. 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 Wow.
Oh. Good thing you didn't choose any. You guys are a powerful combination. All right, Leo, let's see what you can do. Choose Leo. Your panelist.
Creator of Gleeman X, Kevin.
Oh.
Please.
Kevin, you're choosing Kevin.
Sorry.
All right, here we go. Sarah. We've got 45 seconds on the clock. The score to beat is 750. Let's go. English Channel, English Muffin.
English Muffin.
Match. Over the Hill, Over and Out.
Over the Hill.
Match. Land Rover, Landslide.
Landslide.
Match. High Rollers, High Jump.
High Rollers.
No match. Merchant of Venice, Merchant Marine.
Merchant of Venice.
Match. Double Space, Double Bill.
Double Space.
Match. Stick of Gum, Stick in the Mud.
Stick in the Mud.
Match. Touchdown, Touch Tone.
Touchdown.
Match.
Oh my God.
Who Done It, Who Cares.
Who Done It.
Match. Oh my God. Loaded Question, Loaded Dice.
Loaded Question.
No match. Oh. Oh. This matchup, you will see on the panel in front of you, you have three choices. Sarah, because it's a tie game and you won the coin toss, you will choose first. You choose silently your answer on your panel. At any point that you're comfortable. So you selected Leo, you choose second. Either of the remaining options is yours.
This is so tense.
It is.
Okay, now Kevin, because you were the last panelist to play, you will break the tie.
Sorry.
Here is the clue. It is blank top. The options are desktop, bottle top, or spinning top. You just say it out loud.
Yeah, I'm writing down so I don't forget it. I got it.
Oh.
Desk.
Desktop. Desktop, and the winner is Sarah. Sarah, you won. Sarah won. Congratulations. Come up here. Accept your congratulations. Leo, I'm sorry it didn't work out, but it was a great game. We got some great prizes for you backstage. All right, Sarah, come here with me. Sarah wins. Your points are now dollars. You got $800. And we'll be right back, and Sarah will play our Super Batch and Star Wheel round. And Sarah is ready to play our Super Match. We surveyed 100 people across the country and got their best answer to this clue. Epic blank. Now, Sarah, if you guessed the most popular answer we received in our survey, in the next round you will play for $2,000. The second most popular, $1,500. The third most popular, $1,000. But you're not alone. You have your panelists, your friends here to help you. You can choose three of them and get their idea. Well, choose your first panelist.
No, I know.
Eddie.
Oh, why did you?
Eddie. All right, Eddie, what do you got? Blank, epic blank.
Epic movie?
Epic movie.
Epic movie.
Fair enough. All right. Your second one?
Scott.
Scott.
Epic fail.
Epic fail. The audience likes it. And your third panelist?
Kevin.
That was the same movie.
As all of you tried to hide, nobody would make
this
eye contact.
This is a tough one.
What are these two doing?
I was going to say movie. Epic time.
Epic time. We had an epic time.
Yeah,
all right.
Tough.
So we got three answers.
It's a hard one.
This is hard.
It's a hard one.
Yeah,
it's a hard one. So we have epic movie, epic fail, and epic time. You can take one of those, or you can offer your own, Sarah. What
epic
will it
moment,
be?
Epic fail.
Epic fail.
Good choice.
Epic fail.
These people are totally unhip, though.
Yeah.
So we'll see.
We'll see. That's We're looking true. For epic fail. The $1,000 answer was... Epic fail, you're on the board. That's great. Just to satisfy our curiosity, let's see what the other two answers were for $1,500. Epic movie.
Oh, yeah. Or,
well, it was second place. Stop bragging.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And the most common answer we received was epic novel. An epic novel.
What? Who are these people?
Wow.
These are literate people, but you have $1,000 to play with in our Star Wheel round. Okay, this is the Star Wheel. Here's how it works. You spin it. Whoever's name it lands on will be your partner for the final clue. I'll read it off, and we need an exact match between you and your partner. All right? Right now, you're playing for $1,000, but should you land on one of the blinking red lights, it will double to $2,000.
Oh.
Does that sound good? All right, let's give it a spin.
Oh, Eddie.
That's Eddie. Is that Eddie?
That's Eddie.
All right.
Justice is done.
Here we go. I want you to turn and face me. I don't want you to see Eddie writing. So come over here.
Look who neat.
With me. All right, I just want to touch you. All right, Eddie. Here's your clue. You fill this out in silence, say nothing. Spin blank. Spin blank.
That's a hard one.
John is shocked by this.
Not by this one.
No.
Really?
Oh.
One word.
Oh, Eddie.
Eddie, you ready?
Yeah. Oh, there's a couple.
All right. Sarah, you'll give your answer first. The clue is spin blank. Spin.
Class.
Spin class. Right, like exercising at the, in the bikes. All right, I like it. I like it as an answer. Let's turn around. Let's see what Eddie gives us. Eddie, for $1,000, the clue is spin class. Your answer is?
Doctor.
Spin doctor. Spin doctor. That's all right, Sarah. You don't win the $1,000, but you won $800 before, and I think that's great. Congratulations. Thanks for being on the game. If you want to hit Eddie, that's totally fine, because you guys are the same size, so he doesn't really have any kind of advantage. That's it for today's match game. We'll be back next time with our panelists, two new contestants, fun jokes, money. Thanks for watching.